Now, you don't, the feet should be together. They're not supposed to be close to, I mean, as close as it is comfortable. Okay. But they're not supposed to be wide. Okay. We'll begin with the next thing.
Stretch all the way out, or is it just mild?
Mild, okay, you stretch mild.
Okay, the elbows are bent.
Pardon me?
The elbows are bent.
No, they're straight.
Oh, they're straight. Are the shoulders pulled forward?
No.
Okay.
And shoulders, you don't want to lift your shoulders at all.
No, don't lift your shoulders.
Yeah. See, if this comes up, gently. But firmly, okay, there's a firmness to it. You have to feel a firmness and a total softness to it too. So that means you don't really grip it hard, you're gentle. And then this is just a different type of clawing. This is just, you open it up and then you claw and turn. Inhale. butt back and mostly for your really breathing and the idea that
you're opening up the chest here.
Yeah. Really bringing it in the air. But it's not pronounced. You should, if you see me like blowing up, that's wrong. I should be able to really be taking in, but I should not be visible that I'm getting big in the chest, okay? You understand what I'm saying here?
Can the shoulders stretch back?
Yes, I do. When we come back to the chest, it's all, this one, the 18 pieces of, if you put a hand, he's almost done. Just, there he is. Okay, that's fine. You can do it hard just to see how softly you're actually doing, but that should be occasionally. When they say occasionally, that means once or twice a month. If you do it a little, then you go hard and then you would feel the difference. Right? You understand what I'm saying? But that's just to feel how much have you loosened up. It should be night and day. If they're very similar, that means you're putting too much force. You got it? That's only the test. As I understand it, it's only the test for you to see, okay, how gently you're doing it. Okay, and once you come up here, you have to actually exhale. Then you inhale and then exhale. Going down is all exhale, but the thing is if you did it from here, all right, exhaling from here is a little weird, so it's better to go inhale and you have the whole thing to go up here.
Is this straight up?
Yeah, straight up like this.
Straight up.
And then come down in fifth. You come way up here, you come down with the fifth.
Is it straight or
no, slightly slanted. Okay. This is too slanted. This back here is too much. Alright, you want to be slightly off. Not exactly straight, slightly off. Okay. So see if you once you go far too far back, then you're tensing all this up, right? Yeah. We're going to do the picking flowers, and actually we look right first, okay, and then we'll go. Thank you. So I'm revising, okay, going over, raising our palms. And this one's very easy. One. Go back. Two. Three. So what it means is we're doing eight on each side. So that's a total of 16. Okay, so that's how you count it out.
No?
Okay. Yeah. Rest. And this would be in a horse. How it's so different, right? And you have the eight come out a lot. Yeah, this, that one, all right. Especially if your tubby's like this. You barely do it. I mean, it's almost the same, but okay. In the 18 Buddha hands, sometimes they have three, sometimes they have four different moves. They have a moving that you move always eight times, or eight times on each side, and then there's a static posture. The static posture is that okay to allow all the energy just like that increase and rotate. Less so. Engage a little less so. Actually, all the energy, just to feel all the energy flow. Having it at this position, we're having it in this position, we're having it in this position, or this position, with a couple more. But all those positions is to actually feel all your flow in your body. Right? It's a little bit different. Very similar, but it's slightly different. That's why they say they're associated. Right? And that's what scholars say, that actually first the 18 Buddha hands came, and then the eight moves of brocade for the lay monks. The original one is actually supposedly Damo in India. But the 18 Buddha hands came from Damo. India, the teacher of the Shaolin Temple. So he taught this because a lot of the monks did so much meditation, their whole bodies were very weak. So, and since they were vegetarian, I could imagine that so they needed this little bit more strenuous to get their power. And anyway, from that evolved the atheist debate, which was taught to outside people for their health. Okay, that's the story. And that a lot of scholars believe that, you know, the 18th and 18th of the Vulcade, or originated with the 18th of the Vulcade. But before that, there's actually the muscle tendon classic, which is actually one of the highest. And that was only for people to combine their minds and their spirits together. So, but actually, the little bit I know about it, it actually is to loosen all the joints in the body. Right? If you need a really good teacher, I was shown a little bit of it. But they were from Shandong, but they were the best. I came in the 1980s, and I wish I was paying more attention, but I